What is the most significant factor influencing your performance on the day of your exams and on the days leading up to them? Stay tuned to find out and to find out what you can do to minimize its effects. G'day. Welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graham Henderson. After you've studied hard in the days leading up to your exams, the single most important factor going to influence your performance is stress. Physical, emotional, and mental stress. If I asked you to multiply 8 by 8 or 9 by 15, it might take you a few seconds. But if you are threatened with physical or emotional pain while making those same calculations, your mind would tend to freeze up. This is precisely what tends to happen to many students during their exams. They blank out. Now, it may be that they're simply not well prepared, but for many students, it is because of stress. Stress causes you to lose marks that you have studied hard for and that you deserve. Your battle with stress is perhaps the biggest battle that you're going to have around exam time. So here's my list of 7 practical things that you can do to reduce your stress levels and to give yourself the best possible chance to perform well during your exams. Number 1, eat well, drink well, rest well, exercise well, and sleep well. You need your mind and your body in peak working order for your exams. Number 2, don't stay up late cramming the night before your exam. Studies comparing the results of students who cram with those who get a good night's sleep, interestingly, have found no detectable difference between them. It's thought that students who stay up cramming may learn something new for the exam, but on the following day, because of tiredness and poor concentration, lose all those gains through making careless mistakes. It is far more preferable that you get a good night's sleep and arrive at your exam fresh and alert. Number 3, prepare all your necessary equipment on the night before your exam. Make sure it's in good working order and packed before you go to sleep. This will considerably reduce your stress levels the next morning, and you'll be far less likely to forget anything. Make sure you've got spare batteries for your calculator, or perhaps a spare calculator, and make sure you have an adequate number of pens and pencils in case any of them break or run out of ink. Number 4, eat a good breakfast. Avoiding sugars and other foods with a high glycemic index. Many students eat a sugary breakfast, and it causes their blood sugar levels to plummet about an hour and a half afterwards, just at the time they're sitting for their morning exam. It is far better for your blood sugar levels to eat slow energy release foods. It may also help to have a small snack about half an hour before your exam starts. And if you're allowed to take foodstuffs into your exam room, it's good to take a small handful of nuts or some fruit or some other low GI food to snack on about halfway through your exam. Number 5, don't talk to anyone, even your friends, before your exam. Just like Olympic athletes about to race, spend time focusing on the task at hand and take time to relax. Too often, students gather and cluster around the exam room, stressing each other to the point of agitation, comparing notes and things they've studied. Having listened in to a number of these public conversations, I've observed that quite often students will share incorrect information, further stressing and confusing those around them. Avoid these gatherings. Arrive at the venue early, but sit at a distance and only walk over to the exam room when the doors are opened. Number 6, go straight to your desk and don't make eye contact with anyone if possible. I know this may sound rude, but it's in your best interests. You need to maintain your focus. Seeing friends or other students roll their eyes or make distracting gestures, or even worse, under considerable stress, will do nothing to help you. I recommend sitting with your eyes shut, relaxing for a while, or simply looking at the desk in front of you, or looking at the notice board that's usually at the front of the exam room. Number 7. After each exam, it's a good idea not to stay and debrief or to hold a post-mortem with your friends, especially if you have further exams to complete. There is nothing you can do or say will change the results for your last exam. All these gatherings usually achieve is to increase your stress levels rather than decrease them. Now, by all means, socialise and enjoy your friends' company after your last exam is over. But if you want to perform well and keep your stress levels minimised during the exam period, it's wise to avoid these gatherings after each of the previous exams. These 7 simple rules are ones that I've come to adopt over the years as I've had to sit for many exams myself. I hope they help you too. In my next video, I'll be explaining how to sit for a mathematics exam. That is, I'll be giving practical advice about what to do when you're sitting in the exam room during the examination itself. This is Graham Henderson, hoping that you can survive your next group of examinations with a minimum of stress and a maximum of recall and performance. Please subscribe to my channel and like and comment on this video. Thank you.